What is happening, guys? Cowboy here, and we are ready to try and take down the dragon. So, I have been actually fighting this guy for about an hour. Now, originally the plan was to keep all boss deaths in, but I'm not going to upload, like, a two-hour video. So, got an hour of practice against him. I've gotten him really close a couple times. I got down some masterful cheese strats here. I've changed up my stuff quite a few times. So, for one, pyromancy is fucking worthless against this guy. So is dark magic. So, we're not using pyros at all. We put on Ring of Favor, Hornet Ring, and Chlorinthy. I know you can get him with a critical to the face. I haven't seen it yet, but everyone's like, you can critical him to the face. So, I'm gonna try and critical him to the face. That's why I have the Hornet Ring on. Aside from... hang on a second here, real fast. This just looks really sketchy. Okay. Haven't seen it happen yet, but supposedly you can. Other things. I'm using the battle axe because it's good to hit his head. I was using a raw Astora straight sword for a bit, but this battle axe does a little bit more damage than Millwood, so I swapped to that. I also put on Tears of Denial because I'm tired of his fucking dragon charge and dragon breath one-shotting me. Pestilent Mercury ruins his shit, and then Great Heal, so I have more heals. The only other thing I'm thinking about getting rid of some of my Ash Estus, because I have six. And I feel like that's more than needed. So, we're just gonna chill here for a bit. He makes his way over here. He doesn't even work. He just prances around and looks scary. And then ends like that. You can see Pestilent Mercury already working down his health. And I'm gonna just supplement that with some good old axe swings. Anytime I can. No, please stop, sir. Gonna Mercury his ass constantly. When he does this, we're gonna run back and heal. And then do that, because that works really well. Fire shield, of course, helps out a ton. The shield is 100 physical and then like 89 fire. It's a shield exactly, just so I can show you guys. Dragon Crest shield, yeah. Nope! Oh man, Tears of Denial saving my asshole so much right now. Okay. So got a little too cocky there while trying to explain things, but yeah. Basically, the strategy here is to abuse Pestilent Mercury because he's gigantic and he almost always has a part of him that's inside of it. Hack away at his legs with an axe, and then when that's not working, or after he spins around, hit him in the head because he takes more damage in the head. But I gotta say, man, this is not, like, pyromancy, not fun trying to fight this guy. So, like, this is probably the hardest fight I've had so far. Like, the first boss was kind of hard, but I was able to use Dark to get past it. The second boss, you know, definitely hard because a lot of players are just like, fuck you, I'm not getting hit by magic. But thankfully, Black Flame saved the day. Damn it, I forgot to pop this up and then rest at the shrine for free stuff, but whatever. But, you know, being without my pyros or my dark sorceries or my dark pyros, like, it's fucking hard, man. It's like when you have a character that's built around a fucking niche of gameplay, and then that niche is fucking useless in a boss fight. Like, I'm fighting on crutches here. I openly admit this is a total crutch attempt. I'm using everything I can to cheese my way through this. I mean, I got Tears of Denial. I got fucking Pestilent Mercury. But it's like, I'm a pyro. Like, this is my personal hell right now. Gonna let our stamina build back up a bit. Damn it, there's that dragon dash. That thing is fucking brutal. It's killed me so many times. He's gonna roar. He's gonna dash. Okay. Let me get past the Mercury right in his asshole. He seems to really enjoy that, I found. Okay, he's doing his fire. Mercury, and he should turn around, like, right into this if I placed it right. Nope. Did not place it right. please. No, sir. Don't do this. Like, this strat works pretty well. You know, it's very, very reminiscent of, like, Ancient Dragon, Dark Souls 2, you know? Like, I'm basically baiting an attack animation from him, and then using that to abuse him and get behind him where he can't really do shit too effectively. But then he's like, no, I'm gonna fly away, fuck you. Just stay in the Mercury, for fuck's sake. Inside the crotch. I'm literally just burning through Estus at this point, trying to stop him from fucking my shit up. I can't seem to get back into the rhythm of, back into the rhythm I need here. There's the fire. Okay, avoided that. Now turn around. Turn around for me. Helped a lot there. I managed to get that in a really good spot. Now when he turns around, he should be, he's just chilling in the Mercury. That's what we want. Dark explosion. Get out of that. Alright, and this is phase two. Okay, here we go. Alright, I gotta get... Nope, he's doing his lasers. Lasers, get the fuck away! Nope! I'm dead. No, wait. Tears, save me. Well, it was a good attempt, but I think this is the end of it. Alright, it was a good attempt. Almost down. Maybe, like, I don't know, man. That time, I feel like I wasted so much time trying to heal and recast my tears, and heal and recast my tears, that I was just getting fucked up left and right. Like, I really need to, I think what I gotta do here is I gotta keep, like, tears is great. Tears is definitely a huge crutch in this situation, but I need to really focus. Asshole. I need to really focus a lot more on, I think what I'm gonna do here is when I need to stay closer to his face, and when he goes to, like, when he's attacking, get my breath out, get my mercury out, and then that way the mercury is down when he's about to do his breath. Because if the mercury is in place when he turns around, he'll be sitting right in it. And that's going to be huge fucking tick damage on him. And then that way I can focus on the axe. I think part of this is I'm fucking up too much with swapping between mercury and axe. I need to get that down more. And I think I'll be good. Like, I can definitely beat this guy. I just need to fucking get my shit down. And it's not working well playing... I mean, this isn't a playstyle I'm familiar with, you know? Living on a crutch right now, so.
Hello.
Oh no, I'm still going. Still trying to kill the dragon. There's only one dragon. Paige just got home. She's like, "So how's it going?" I'm like, "Yep, still getting molested by the dragon." Alright, dodge that. Okay. Let me try to change up my tactic a little bit here. Because he likes to do this. If I'm behind him, he's going to just turn around with it. But if I'm... Now, stop that. If I'm, like, right on his side... Damn, that hits fucking hard. Probably fucking dumb. Yep. That tail is fucking me up really badly. This is one of those times where I really wish I was on New Game so this guy didn't hit like a Mack truck. Just because that order makes a little bit more sense, because if I get hit, I'm going to want to pop tier again real fast, and then greater heal. Which I got, I mean, I had some good opportunities there. I think where I'm fucking up the most... Damn it, you always fucking hit me, you stupid, goddamn red-hooded fuckface. God, I hate that thing. Because every time I go the wrong direction, it's, ah, I'll stab you. I'm like, fucking asshole. The tail has taken me out. Now. So the big things I need to focus on. The laser breath, I'm avoiding that successfully. Plus I got tears. So that's going to save my ass if I end up whiffing and missing that. His dragon charge, I'm able to shut that down pretty well with the shield and sidestepping to the right. So the big thing right now I need to work on avoiding is the tail swipe. I need to focus on rolling a lot more too. Like, the camera is honestly one of the biggest fucking bosses in this battle. The camera is just horrendous. It's like you lock on and then you're like half clipping through the dragon. You can kind of see what he's doing, but not. And it's like, I think he always does that. So there's probably literally no point in running towards him at the start. Okay, there's his combo. No, why am I casting Great Heal in the fire like an asshole? That was stupid. This is actually going really well so far. I shouldn't have said anything though, I probably just jinxed it. There's the dragon dash. So I need Mercury while he's doing his fire cast. Get two swipes in on the tail. And then a fucking heavy to the face, damn it. A heavy missed. Still kind of hanging out in my Mercury. He's gonna turn around like right here, I think. Come on. Ouch, that one hurt a lot. That hurt a lot too. Explosion. fuck. Heal, but I'm gonna be careful. I'm not gonna fucking go heal half cocked. I'm gonna wait until he prances past just like that. No, shit. Okay. That's okay. It's okay, we're okay. Right under him. He does this thing for a little bit. I can get up a new tiers. I can get up a new fucking great heal. Fuck me. I can do this. I just use my divine. Please take this guy out. Is he down? Oh my god. Dude, my fucking heart rate right now is like through the roof. Like, we're at 25 minutes in the video, but there was a solid, like, I don't even know, hour and a half of attempts against this thing. Like, like, if y'all could feel my pulse right now, it's fucking nuts. Oh, fuck that thing, man. I wanted to start the fucking, like, walkthrough prep tonight on the stream, and that's obviously not happening, because it's... What time is it? It's already... Let's see. It is 10 o'clock now, so this video will probably be up by, like, 11. And then there's still one more boss that I want to try and take out before bed. At 302,000 fucking souls. That's good. Unfortunately, I don't think anybody sells embers anymore, which blows fucking dick. I would love embers. I'll take 3 of these. I guess I'm just gonna take like 11 of those and like 6 of those. I mean, I don't know. There's not much else I can take. I need embers, please. From Soft, infinite embers. So let's see, what do we get from this thing? We get Frayed Blade Katana, a dragon weapon symbolizing Darkeater and Midir. The once exquisite blade is now stained black and frayed at the hilt. Without its sheath, it'll soon crumble into nothing. Hold. Assume a holding stance in which a normal attack sends a shockwave along to earth and a strong attack commences a series of slashes. Sounds pretty badass. What else is there? Oh. Old Moonlight Sorcery. Conceive Old Moonlight Sword and attack. A memory of the old sword found deep within Midir. The sorcery uses souls to grant form. Grant form to the attack and attack with it. Attacks are coupled with light waves, and sustaining the stance before attacking increases their speed and potency. The sword is named after Moonlight, but it is slightly different than the one fashioned of the Pale Drake Seath. Perhaps it is rooted in an older memory from not long after the beginning. So this is like what... It's a whole fucking sorcery dedicated to Moonlight Greatsword. 25. Conceive. That makes it sound like you're giving birth to it. Well, this guy does not sorceries at all, so we're gonna... I'll get the sword. Let's check this out. 40 dex! Holy shit! And it has B scaling at base. And it has some built-in bleed. This is the new dex weapon. This is like what dex people have been waiting for. The length on this thing is pretty sick. That's going to send shockwaves along the ground. And then this is going to go... Oh, that's badass. Look at that. That's like some fucking Neo shit. FromSoft's like, we can do fucking fast slashing katanas too. Not only Neo. Like, I kind of want to make a dex guy just to use that sword. That's badass. Whew. All right. Either way, we got one more boss left, baby. We got Big Papa Gale. Probably going to go back to full pyromancy for him. So either way, make sure to stay tuned, and we will catch you guys with the final boss.